Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Those who are new, welcome to my channel. In our last videos, we have learned about the reasons of renaissance. After that, we see the features of renaissance. In that, we see most important reasons or causes of renaissance. After that class, we have seen the features of renaissance. In today's class, we discuss a very important topic called literature of renaissance. What are the literature of Renaissance on that time? The Italy was a motherland of great writers. We are all know that Italy was a motherland of great writers like France, England, Germany and Spain. To the contributed a lot to literature. In here we see that in the European countries like French, England, Germany and Spain have been contributed a lot to the literature. Many books have been written in those countries. The theme of the literature of this period was worldly matter rather than the religion. Before that, the main theme of books were religion, but after in the period of Renaissance, we see that the theme of the writers or the theme of the book is worldly matters. What are held in the whole over the world, those kind of things they discuss in their book. On that time, they did not given more important to the religious matters in their own area. The many articles were written about the human body and voice and other subjects. Instead of the Latin, the many other regional European languages come to be used in the daily life. Here we see that except the religion, the peoples have been thought about all matters like the many articles have been written in human bodies and voice. Those have been written in other subjects also. Instead of the Latin, Latin was a ancient language, and it was instead of this language, the many regional languages have been come into existence and they use in their daily life. Those are all about the literature. Now let us see Petrarch. 1304 to 1374 CE, the Petrarch is known as the father of Renaissance. He is known as the father of Renaissance. He collected about 200 Latin and Greek manuscripts. Africa is a famous poem of his. Here we see that he was collected about 2200 Latin and Greek manuscripts. Africa was a great and famous poem which are written by him. It is in Latin. He was a well known for the poem and sonnet. Sonnet means the 14 line which are fixed rhymes. He was most famous to write the poem called Sonnet. A deep contemplation of men's happiness and sorrow can be seen in this poem. In his poem, he has totally elaborated the deep sorrowness and happiness of the men in his poem. After that, we see a collection of 100 stories called Decameron, written in Italian by Boccaccio, the famous work Divine Comedy by Dante, Canterbury Tales, which are written by Chaucer of England, Don Quixote, written by Cervantes of Spain, Utopia, written by Thomas More of England, are all the notable works. Here we see that the many poem, many writers have been written many books like the Decameron was written by Boccaccio. He is an Italian writer and a famous work called Divine Comedy has been written by Dante, and Canterbury Tales was written by Chaucer of England. Those things like Utopia was written by Thomas More, and after that we see William Shakespeare was an excellent poet and dramatist. He wrote numerous tragedies and comedies. St. Paul's School established in London, dedicated to the acquisition of a new knowledge. Those are all about the literature. Now let us see Renaissance art. Art and architecture are art and sculpture. During this period, the art was a simple and natural. Artist draw the moral showing mythological character Jesus Christ, and this follows with a natural human emotions. Here in the Renaissance art and architecture, we see that the people have been given more importance to the simple and natural art, and they have been given importance to the like mythological characters and like Jesus Christ and their followers in natural human emotions. They are like very much this type of architectures. Now let us see, there were many artists in Italy during the 16th century. Michelangelo, Raphael, Leonardo da Vinci and Titian were the important artists. Michelangelo, Adam and Final Decision, Leonardo da Vinci, Last Supper and Mona Lisa, Raphael's Sistine Madonna, Titian's Assumption of a Virgin were the most famous painting of Renaissance period. Those are all about the art and literature of Renaissance. In the art and literature, we see the prominent paintings. First, in the literature, we see the prominent books and writers of the Renaissance period. After that, we see the art and architecture of the Renaissance. Here, we see the important architectural work of that time, and we see the important work of Renaissance period. We see those are all about the literature and art and architecture of Renaissance. If you have any queries regarding this, comment below. Thank you for watching this.